Yeah, we got a lot of parts here. Okay, might as well get into it. Guys, today I'm going to be putting together my new computer. This has been a long time in the making. There has been several computers lately that started crashing because I've been home a lot more, been using them a lot more, started playing video games a little bit, and they just started crashing. And I'm talking like power supply issues. I don't know what else is going on, but they're computers that are over 12 years old, and it's a matter of, do you pump money into repairing a computer that's 12 years old, or do you just go ahead and put together a new one and pull the hard drives and put everything into the new computer? And that's kind of where I'm sitting at the moment. By the way, this video is brought to you by Uncle Sam and my tax refund. That's pretty much how, the only way I could even afford to even do this. I wanted to put together a computer that's going to last quite a while, so that's the reason why I went with the i7 processor and went that direction. I was going to go AMD. I was going to go with the 5800X, but after I got everything all set, put it in my cart, and went to buy it, and it was out of stock. And finally, I'm like, you know what? For a little bit less, it actually turned out to be a lot less. I could actually go with the i7 11700K. So that's the route I went. So just going over what we have here. I did go with the 11th gen core i7 11700K. It's got 8 cores, 16 thread. It's got a base clock of 3.6 gigahertz and 5.0 turbo. This is like a $344 CPU. I found it on Mercari for $280, $290. Out the door after tax and shipping, it was $318.66. So I saved a little bit of money there that I was able to put into other things. Next thing is decided to go with the MSI MPG 590 gaming motherboard. I got it on Amazon for $198.99. Fuma 2 to cool this monster. This is the Revision B, and it went for $65.99. I wanted something that I knew would handle the cooling for this, because everything said it was a pretty hot chip, so I figured that would be the way to go on it. I didn't want to go water cooling because I don't want to deal with maintenance. For the memory, I went with Team Group T-Force Dark 32 gigabyte kit, so 216 sticks of RAM, DDR4 3600 megahertz. That was $116.99. That was the lowest price I could find anywhere on Amazon, and that was on Amazon. Samsung 980. Actually, when I ordered it, it was supposed to be a 970, and somewhere along the line it got upgraded to a 980. I don't know when or how, but got to upgrade to a 980 for $99.99. It's a 1 terabyte NVMe SSD. Then I went ahead and I went with a Radeon RX 6600 graphics card. This was it wasn't the lowest price one I could find, but it was the one that I felt more comfortable with. The other one was a little bit longer card. It was a little bit less, but it didn't have a full back plate to it. I just didn't feel comfortable with it. This one here I thought would look really good in it. So that's the route I went. Spent a little bit more on it. Pretty much the savings from the CPU. And that was $399.99. It was $430.99 after shipping, tax, and all that. I do not do notes. I keep notes.
Ditto. Ad-libbing for the win.
I know, right? For the power supply, that's where we've got kind of a story behind it. This is not the first power supply I picked up. The original I picked up was a Be Quiet 750 watt. Just on a hunch, we opened it up, and it did not have a second different people call it the EPM cable or something like that. It's pretty much for the second slot on the motherboard for the CPU power. This motherboard requires 2 8-pin power connectors for the motherboard. That one only came with one. So I scrambled really quick, got this one in yesterday, day before, I think it was. And this, of course, is the MSI MPG 850GF 850-watt full modular power supply rated at 80 plus gold. It was $119.87, which hurt because that kind of took me a little bit over my budget. But it's all right because it's got everything I need. And plus it's MSI, so this has kind of turned into an MSI build by accident, I guess. I don't know.
I was just going to say, I'm looking at the motherboard, the power supply, and the graphics card and going,
I didn't do it purposely, but that's just kind of where the cookie crumbled, you know? The case. This one is probably took me longer to figure out what case to get of all of it. Went through PC Part Picker. That was another thing, too, about the power supply. PC Part Picker said the other one would work and didn't say there was any issues. Now, any other power supply I chose said, oh, you're going to have a problem with the 8-pin power connector. 8-pin. Not with that other one. It said, no, you're fine. Ordered it. No, I wasn't fine. So, I'm hoping that the rest of it goes good. So, I decided to go with this Musetex mid-tower ATX PC case. This one came with 620 millimeter RGB fans, and it was on Amazon for $109.99. It's not the cheapest case I could have went with, but I wanted something with tempered glass so that it wouldn't scratch up from just dust in the air. Also wanted something that came with the fans. And I figured a little bit of RGB probably wouldn't hurt. I think other than the motherboard, this is the only thing that has a little bit of RGB to it. What else do we got? After the fact, I decided I wanted to go with one more storage media. I wanted to go one more hard drive. So I went with the Barracuda. It's a Seagate Barracuda 4 terabyte SSD or SATA hard drive. It was $69.99 on Amazon, and I, since it is a mechanical drive, I went ahead and I picked up the 3-year data recovery plan for $14.99, bringing the total to $90.40 for that hard drive. It's insane to me that you can get a 4 terabyte hard drive for under $100, because for so long you couldn't even find a 1 terabyte for less than $200 for a long time.
I remember, I think I bought a 2 or 3 terabyte drive. This was before I was even living. This was when I was going to the Bay Area. I got it at Fry's with my dad for, I think, like $130. Yeah. Because 1 terabyte was $100 and 3 terabyte was like $30 more. And it's like, that's a way better deal.
Yeah, it is.
Thinking so, I'd never fill up a terabyte drive, and here I am with multiple terabytes of footage.
Yeah. And the reason why I went with a 4 terabyte drive is because, once again, I am planning on moving all the photos, files, and everything from the other computers. And we're talking probably about 3-4 computers I'm going to be pulling all those files into. And I need some storage for it. Eventually, I do plan on putting a second one in, but I'll have to wait until money frees up a little bit better, and then that's the plan. That's the thing about this computer is it's, I believe that it's going to allow me to add more to it over time compared to if I would have went another route. Grand total, after tax, shipping, and everything for all of this, was $1,607.03. So it's essentially a $1,600 computer. So why did I go this route compared to just buying a computer? A reason why is because the closest one I could find for the money was going to be over $2,000. It was going to be through Dell for an Alienware computer. Differences would have been, I would have went with a 11th gen Core i7 11700KF, which from what I understand is not an unlocked CPU, so you can't do any overclocking whatsoever with it. It would have been a GeForce RTX 3070 with 16 gigabytes of RAM and 1 terabyte SSD. And it would not let me do upgrades. I could not add memory. I could not add hard drives to it. it didn't want to let me do anything. Now, back in the day, I used to be able to order them from Dell and add anything I wanted to for it, as long as I was willing to pay for it. Not anymore. For some reason, they got all locked down where it's like probably already built, put in a box somewhere, who knows. So the whole idea behind this was I could add as much RAM as I want, and for a lot less, turns out. Yeah, it did take a little bit of hit on this particular card, because I could have went with a 3070, but it would have increased the price by a bit. I think it was the closest one I thought was like $500 or something I found. But as much gaming as I do, which is not much, this is going to be just fine. It's mainly going to be for video editing. It's going to be for downloading photos as far as, I mean, scanning them through a scanner, going through Photoshop to correct any scratches and tears in the photos or anything that way, trying to repair them. So I needed something that was going to have horsepower to do it, and I figured this one's going to do it. Enough jibber jabber, time to move on, and let's get this sucker built. I got my tweezers.
Oh, God.
Okay. Remember, that will be toward the end. I'll need that sooner than later. This can go with this.
It's flat.
What was that?
Yeah. Nobody cares.
Nobody cares.
Here, do you want me to set some stuff off to the side?
No, we're good.
All right. Do you need a knife?
No, that's one thing I forgot.
Oh, the Christmas present.
Ooh.
That thing is so nice, dude. Thanks again.
You're welcome.
You do not know how many times that thing comes in handy at work.
This is the thing that's been kind of worrying me.
Uh-huh.
Is exactly what did I get myself into with this case. But we'll see. So, it's got a glass panel on the back. It's got mesh on the front. So it's going to have plenty of airflow, and that's what I wanted. It's going to have your power button, LED button, USB 3. I thought it was supposed to have USB 2 on the top too, but it's only got two slots for USB 3, which is fine. Almost everything is anymore. And it's got our audio and audio ports on top. And this case is magnetic. Yes, I believe it is.
Nice.
Take that off, put it away so I don't break it, because you know me, I will break it. Okay, so here we got our Z590. Let's go ahead and open that up. The reason why I went with this board is because if I did want to overclock, I can. Once again, it's got the two 8-pin powers that goes to the board up there. It does have where I can put the NVMe on it, so I'm going to go ahead and do that now, I think. Here we go. So it's going to need to go up to that right here. I think I'm going to need a smaller screwdriver than that. There we go. So that is in place along with this thermal pad, so that should be good. Next thing I'm going to want to do is go ahead and install my CPU. Now, I also know I have to set up everything for the bracket for the cooler. So let's go ahead and pull the cooler out and just see what we have going on there. Ooh. How is it going to fit?
Yeah, it should be fine.
Should be fine. PC part picker would have kicked it, would have found the problem, right? You know you're in trouble whenever you have to pull out the instructions. Yep, so there is actually a piece that goes behind it, so let me get that figured out. Oh, I get it now. So I already put the M.2 in.
Nice.
So I'm having to move all the legs on this in a 1/8 of an inch or whatever that is.
One notch.
Yeah, one notch. And now...
Oh! Nice.
Okay. So they got a little bit of foam or something.
I think that you'd want that going onto the PC board. So
oh, rubber... Yeah, rubber down to the PC board.
So you're less likely to crack it.
It's nerve-wracking when you haven't done this in years.
And you're just looking at like hundreds of dollars and stuff like, and I want to screw this up.
The last computer I built was in 2000, actually.
Oh, wow.
Because back when they had Windows Millennium or whatever it was. I forget what they're called.
Yeah.
I think we need to install the CPU before we go
any further. I think that'd be a good idea.
Let's see. I think you poke that down. Yep. Raise that up. Now, the Intel board has all the pins there. Mm-hmm. Where if I had AMD, all the pins would be on the CPU like it used to be back when I last built a computer. When I last built a computer, that's where the pins were on Intel. They were on the CPU. Mm-hmm. So from what I understand, the CPU now has these little, just the pads on it.
Interesting. Which, it is pretty funny though. Oh.
See there? It's all flat.
Yeah.
That's cool.
That was actually really clever.
And
there's got to be a registration key.
There is.
Okay, good.
There's these little nubs that are right there on the side of the socket.
That's clever.
Can see the little cutouts? Yeah. Do this in a way where I don't drop it.
Plank.
Cat hair.
Dang it.
And from what I understand...
Don't you have to remove the plastic cover?
No. Plastic cover removes itself, from what I understand.
Uh-huh.
Make sure I cut that. Is
it? Yeah, that's seated, I think. Oh.
And you want to put that away in case we ever take it back apart. We want to protect that socket.
Right.
I guess. I don't know.
Put it somewhere that we'll forget it in 5 minutes.
Exactly. We'll never see that again. It just disappeared.
Yeah, that sounds about right for out here.
Okay, so the question is, which one of these do we use? Because I see that there's actually two different ones. I guess we just see which one fits. Okay, so that one doesn't fit, so it's got to be this one. How about that for a way of figuring it out? I need that one. And they have these pieces facing inward, right? Yes, they do.
Yeah, they do. So the next you apply the thermal compound?
No. Next, we apply these things to.
Well,
did we do those or did we do the ones with the tops?
You do the ones with the plus cut in the top of them.
Okay.
Yeah. Then we apply the compound and then we apply the cooler.
Yeah. I could do my Jackson Fuller painting.
Oh, gosh.
I learned so much from The Verge.
Alright, I forget your front screen doesn't work. It's not turned on. So I'm assuming it's recording.
It's flashing, it's...
No, no, I mean like it's recording this thing going on.
Oh, Lord. Is that what this is for? Oh, it is! Screw with confidence.
Who's going to be editing this video? Probably me.
Either one. Okay, so we have that in place. Now we do the thermal paste. Do we do it like it says to do it here? Do we just put the glob on there?
I think Linus kind of figured out that there's like no real wrong way to put thermal paste on. Are you not using like icy diamond or liquid
used to
metal?
You went with a pea size right in the center.
That's fine. It's gonna smush out.
And then
out
Gamer anyway. Nexus, I think, says you have to do like a line and a dot. I don't know. Just I'm gonna do it like I used to do it.
I think it'll be fine. We're not doing insane things with this thing.
There. That's that should be plenty. Oh, Lord.
Stop psyching yourself out.
Okay, so let's see here.
Yeah, like
that's
that.
That's not going to work. That's not going to work. It's got to go this way. It's got to go that way. Yeah. Oh, okay. Almost made a no-no. Almost made a no-no.
Why is our computer overheating in 3 seconds?
Okay, wait. I'm just going to add just a hair more. It looks like a lot right there, but it's really not.
Uh-huh. You're not going to use Tech Grandpa's thermal epoxy?
No.
Oh.
Okay. I'm so nervous about this.
Do you want me to do it for you?
No.
Okay.
I don't want to blame you for the rest of my life. Calvin, it's all Calvin's fault.
That's the story of my life, dude. Yep.
I'm probably overcomplicating this whole thing.
Yes. I've never built a computer in my life, and I'm looking at this going, it's really not that scary.
It's not that scary. It's just, I haven't done it in so long. Oh, there it goes.
Yeah.
I think you just do it until it stops.
Yeah.
The picture doesn't say...
And then I would alternate back to the other side so you're not
an
even point.
It's bottoming out. It's bottoming out on that bracket.
Okay.
But the good thing is, since we just barely set it down and it was already starting to squish out on that plastic, we know it's going to squish out.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, I don't see anything sticking out past it as far as... So,
yeah.
We should be good. Now, how in the world we hook up the fan? Oh my god, what in the world is going on here?
Yeah, so then the wires clip into the fans to hold it in place.
Okay. So there.
And there.
Oh!
It's clever.
That actually is. That's kind of cool. Okay, so now we'll pull off these because I got tweezers to tear everything back later. I'm using zip ties.
Don't make me smack you silly on camera, sir.
Okay, so see this right here was the CPU fan. So the FUMA comes with the fan splitter. So all I got to do is hook that there. And then I've got our two connectors here. We now have our cooler on our CPU. We have our NVMe in place. The next thing will be RAM. And I did sneak peek at the manual. It goes in the second slot and the fourth slot, I guess that would be.
Yeah.
Memory of the Soul has 32 gigs there. Got that, got that. What else am I forgetting here? Anything for now? No.
Oh, that actually, in the case.
Actually, now it's pretty much ready to go in the case.
Wow.
I don't think they have all of them in there. Because I'm looking over here and I'm seeing a that's not got standoffs in it. So that's probably what this other little bag is probably our standoffs. Okay, there's standoffs. See on the case here? See how it says A for ATX, mm-hmm. M for micro ATX, and then I for ITX. So anywhere there's an A, you have to have a standoff. So, okay, go through and put the standoffs where they are missing, which is just going to be, I believe, three of them.
There we go. Now we can get some inside the case.
And these standoffs are way smaller than they used to be. You see one more standoff there?
Right there.
There it is. I should put my glasses back on.
Well, it helps their dark item on a dark surface.
I know.
That's asking for trouble.
Poor life choices. I don't know about your camera there.
We'll see. Here, let me get on the other side of this so I can see.
Oh, that should be fine.
Yeah, I mean, it's getting something. That's the worst that can happen. We use it for 2 minutes of footage and go, wow, it was great.
Okay, so that fan cable up there is in the way.
Need me to adjust anything? Let me know.
Yeah, I need where that camera's at. I gotta move things around and find out what's going on here because I am having a hard time getting the IO shield past that fan.
Here's the problem, you got the fan cable right here.
I know.
Here. Okay, try sliding it in now. There we go.
That's it. And that screwdriver is not magnetized. Great! And my toolbox is buried. Does the screwdriver magnetize by any chance? Yes, it is. That will work. You know, if I was a smart person, I would have put those cables in for the two 8-pin power connectors.
Oh well.
Yeah, I can get my hand in there. Next thing is going to be power supply.
Nice.
Ooh, this is fancy. That much money, it better be. Or come with a happy ending, too. Nice. Okay, that's fancy.
That is fancy. Wow, and it even comes with a kind of bag. Not like we don't have 100 of those.
Wow.
Dang.
That's pretty.
MSI really.
I guess that way I got a place to put any extra cables on there. Go ahead. So now is when I gotta start making decisions. What power am I going to need for all this stuff? So by default, this one's got to go because that one's it's going to supply all the power to the motherboard on that side. This one's a SATA cable. I'm going to need that for
the
drive. Not for this one, but for the second drive that I'm going to be putting in. Second SATA, I don't think I'll need. What's this one? PCIe, I'll need that more than likely for the
SSD.
No, graphics card.
Oh.
I don't think I'll need two PCIe's. I'll hold it off right here anyway. Molex, not sure. I gotta take a look. 8-pin, definitely need that. Got all kinds of PCIe's, I don't need those, but the 2 8-pins, that's the whole reason why I got this. I'm so happy to see that they actually are here. Well, the power supply goes down here in the basement.
Okay, so looking at this, all the plugs are in the back, so right. I would pre-plug everything in and then stick it in.
And the only thing is, it's going to go that way.
Whatever. The point being,
the reason why it's going to go that way is because it does have the vent down there, so you want to suck the air there. You could turn it over and do it that way, but
whatever. Let's suck up more carpet dust.
Yeah. Now, actually, this power supply mounts from the inside, I believe.
Yeah. Personally, I would mount it going the other way, just so you're not sucking cat hair all day.
Yeah, but that's not what you're supposed to do with these.
Right, but I don't think everybody's house has a ton of cat hair in it either. It's up to you.
Well, it does have the filter.
Yeah, but the filter's going to get clogged real fast.
True.
I would flip it upside down, personally.
So if anybody's yelling at me...
It was my fault. I said to flip it the other way. Because I know the conditions this thing's going to live in.
Don't be that way about kitty cats. Okay, so... we're going to need an 8-pin. It's just... I should have done that while it was out. Okay, and there should be another 8-pin. CPU. There it is. Okay, that's the ones that had me worried.
Yeah.
See, back in the day when we did computers, there was no such thing as cable management. The back panel was as tight as it could be to everything. So there was no... the cables just dangled everywhere. You open up any computer right now that's a... like a Dell or any of those, and the wires are going to be everywhere. Because that's just the way things were done. Now things are all like fancy and pretty and...
I mean, I'm for making things organized, but there also comes a point where you're like, it's a little overkill.
Yeah.
You know, I get it. Everybody has their favorite way of doing things, and that's awesome. But some people, I think, get a little neurotic over it. But that's just me.
You've been outvoted, Calvin.
It goes the other way.
Yep.
Whatever.
There's no other way of doing it.
That's fine.
The way the case is set up, the holes only go one direction.
Hey, you know what? I'm looking at it from the standpoint of how I would do it, but that doesn't mean that there aren't constraints out of my control, such as the case. Here.
USB 3. Goes down there. So we'll take our USB 3 and push it in from underneath. Okay. USB 3 is in place. Oh man, that's killing my back. And then power switch. Does not say positive or negative. Don't think it matters because it's a momentary switch. It's a DLED header. DLED header.
I mean, the real question is, how important is the RGB to hook up right now?
It's
one wire left, so it's like, why not?
Fair.
J Rainbow?
Yeah.
Okay, that works.
And then RGB LED wire is a cluster if I ever saw one.
Yeah.
Note to self, if I get a case, I don't think I'm getting RGB in it for that very reason. It's just that much more of a headache. Fit.
Perfect. And then pull that wire down.
Oh yeah, it's kind of wrapped around whatever this guy is.
Yeah, that's right. I can work around that. Okay, so that's going to go to the power supply. This is connected to that wiring harness. That one goes up there to that. Is there any wires I am missing? No. It's just that needs to be connected. Then you hook up my hard drive. So I might as well pull it out, get it in the cage. Man, I am out of practice. I was used to taking these a lot faster.
How many years has it been again?
22 years?
Yeah. I wouldn't expect you to be... I mean, things have changed a bit.
Well, yeah, because back in the day, there were jumpers that you had to put on the motherboard. There were also jumpers you had to put on here. I swear to God, it said slave, and it said... master.
That's common electronics terminology. I'm not even kidding.
Racist bastards.
I'm not kidding. That is
not
electronics terminology.
It's like, my God.
Because, okay, I'm not going to explain it because nobody's going to care, but I understand why they chose that terminology because one was telling the other what to do and it would mimic it. But, whatever.
There were other ways.
No.
Look at this. I'm trying to figure out how I want to. I think it only mounts one direction on here. And that's going to be right here. I thought it was enough room for two hard drives. But I don't think so. Oh, unless one of them fits on top. Well, if that's the case, I'll have to take the cage out anyway when the time comes to put the second one in.
Got it.
So, it doesn't really matter. Okay. There it is.
Wow.
And then, that cable, I think is going to... Yep, they made it difficult. Actually, better off doing it that way.
Yeah, especially if you throw in a second one.
And then I might as well just use that top one for this thing. I was trying to figure out where in the world to mount this thing, because it's actually got two-sided tape on it.
Some VHP. I would just do it, like, right there.
That's kind of what I'm thinking, too.
Gosh, I love VHP tape, and I hate VHP tape all in one. Yeah, that should be good.
Give it the little wiggle.
Yeah. That shouldn't go anywhere.
Famous last words.
No, we use VHP tape over at work to hold certain things down, and trust me, once you squeeze that thing down, it don't want to come up. It's amazing.
Yes, Calvin, I cussed.
Don't worry, I'm looking over at the camcorder like that thing's running on one bar of power at this point. We're 2 hours in.
There.
Got it.
There it is.
Hooray.
Technically, I could power it up now.
Do we want to give it a shot?
Yeah, kind of.
Yeah, let's check
see
this.
See if we're even
close.
In the same ballpark. Shut down. If you want to pull the HDMI cable from the back of that computer.
Yeah.
Oh, we're not done. Son of a bitch. I was getting all excited. We were getting so far. We were almost done. Then I just realized I gotta go back now because I forgot to put the graphics card in it.
Forgot to put the Red Dragon in.
Got the graphics card. Forgot the cable on the power supply unit. Which means now I just gotta take everything back apart because I'm an idiot.
We'll just put that as the intro. Oh, jeez.
What a happy day.
Let's build a computer, they said.
A computer is simple.
It's so much fun. Wait. We're going to slightly stage something here. Don't use too much language, but I'm going to film a quick fake rant of you as you're trying to build the thing to put on Twitter.
What do you mean a fake rant? There ain't nothing fake about it. I go and I get the computer all put together and I forget one small detail. I forgot to put the stupid card in it. So now, I gotta take the whole thing back apart, put the stupid cable in for the PCIe. Does it take a PCIe? Yes, it does.
Eh, this is the joys of filming, building a computer, guys. Whoever said it was fun...
Well, in all fairness, I haven't done it for 22 years, so... But even at that, back at that time, they didn't really have graphics cards. It all was on board stuff.
Blah, blah, blah.
Let's face it, all you could do is look at porn on stinking monochrome monitors.
I am so happy to edit that.
No, it's... Actually, that was before that. Okay. There's a saving grace here. Okay, in all fairness, look at this. I forgot to put screws inside the hard drive, so the hard drive cage came out, which means by rights, because I'm an idiot and didn't put the screws in there, it actually saved me a little bit of time here. I think I can fit this in there. I'll figure out where the PCIe goes inside here without having to take that power supply back apart.
I'll put it this way. Well, I'm not saying I'm going to go out and build my own computer tomorrow. In a way, it's kind of like, okay, this isn't as bad as I thought it would be.
No, it's not bad. And honestly, if I had a different case,
yeah,
this whole thing would have been a lot easier.
I think, honestly, if I was to get a case, I would not get one with RGB in it. Just because it's... I mean, I can always go back and add lighting in later if I really wanted to, but for me, it's like, it's not worth the price.
I didn't buy it because of the RGB. I bought it because of the fans.
Yeah, I know.
If it, the RGB was just kind of a, okay, well, I'll make it look pretty. You know, that's fine.
For me, it's like...
But that's not why I bought it. I bought it strictly because of the I strictly bought it because of the fans.
No, I know. I'm just saying if I was to do one, I might just get a plain case and then add in my own stuff, but whatever.
Yeah.
You know. Neither here nor there. Definitely not knocking your decision, though. I think it is pretty cool.
By the time you go and you buy a $108 case, and if you hadn't bought the $108 case, you go and you spend, let's say, $75 on a case that may come with one fan.
Yeah.
So then you start looking into pricing fans. Before you know it, when you buy, you know, another few fans, you're suddenly, you're up there in price. And it's, that's where I, the point I came to is like, wait a minute, if I go and I do this and you know, skimp here in order to get a cheaper case, and then have to buy fans, I'm really not saving any money. So that's the reason why I went the route I went.
No, I totally get it. It's one of those darned if you do, darned if you don't situations.
Yeah. So it's like, eh, you know what, I'll just do it this way. I'll tidy up these cables later. Sure, that's what everybody says.
Nobody cares.
Okay, I have my PCIe cable now. Now I can take and put the graphics card in. Let's see if I can mess that up now. Okay, my back is killing me, man. Back is straight up killing me right now. Okay, so they say take the one that's in line with it, which would be this one right here. You know what? Just thinking back on it, on my decision here, I thought there was supposed to be a way of putting a riser or something here. I don't remember seeing that with this case, though. I remember them saying something about you could put a card upright in it.
Hmm.
But, oh well. How in the world do I get those out? I gotta take that loose. Yep. Pull that out in order to pull this out. At least I don't have to break any tabs. Last time I did this, I had to break tabs out, and now you can just remove the little piece. That's cool. Well, it's two slot. Pull that out. Okay. Nice backplate to it. That's pretty.
I'm gonna get it in there.
What am I missing here?
You're not hitting the slot. There.
There she is.
Yeet.
Okay.
And once we get this thing to boot, we should probably stop filming because the camcorder's battery is looking pretty low.
Yeah, I need to take it right over to Hollister anyway, so we can come back later and finish up any loose ends on it. I mainly just want to see if it powers up.
Yeah.
That would look cool though, upright.
Yeah, nah, that's for another time.
Yeah, but just I'm trying to remember if it. I thought it was supposed to come with the means to do that.
Well, you can figure that out later.
Okay. There we go. Now I need to run my PCIe through the lower thing right here.
No, I was going to say, when you get done with this, I need to film some stuff today, so.
Yeah?
Yeah. So, don't worry.
Really? I've got to run that whole thing through there? Really don't want it. visible. It looked better with that one. It looked better with that one, won't it?
Yeah. Oh, the main camcorder just died.
Hey, here's the battery.
Okay.
I will have to figure out how I want to do that.
Just zip tie it on there.
I don't want it inside there like that, though. That looks hokey as...
Whatever.
Anyway, preliminary, that's what I've got. Now, let's see if it'll actually fire up. You have the HDMI cable?
Yeah.
That's the one to this monitor here, right?
Yeah. Yeah, let me move the camera in closer so we can document the...
That's HDMI? Nope, that's not HDMI.
That's HDMI.
That's HDMI. There we go. So, if you plug that in up here, which you can, I think somebody said there's onboard graphics, but I'm not for sure. Okay. Ready for a moment of truth?
Yep. Whoa! Hey, I gotta kill the lights for a second. Whoa!
What was that you said about RGB? Uh-oh.
It died. It was nice knowing it. Oh, there goes again.
Oh, light just turned... Yay, we got lights on the screen. Boy, I need to clean that screen. CPU or memory change. Please enter setup, configure system. Okay. Well, you know what? For now,
we're calling this a success.
Well, at the moment. We'll come back in a little bit. I'm going to take a break from it. And then I will come back and see what needs to be done on it.
Yeah.
I don't know. Maybe a different video. Maybe the same video. Oh, there you go. MSI. It booted. So.
Nice.
Ooh, I got fingers on prints on glass already. No.
So I don't like tempered glass side panels.
I love tempered glass. How about that?
No, I think it's a fingerprint. The top one's not in.
I'm trying to get my fingerprints on it.
Just admit it. It's going to happen.
No.
She made one pin a little longer.
PC Master Race.
Oh gosh, no. I feel like that thing is so toxic sometimes.
Okay, so how does this thing work? Somehow there's a green thing here. It's supposed to work. How does that work?
Oh my.
How's it work?
Literally,
I'm not seeing it.
Literally can't even right now. This thing is...
That cooler could not be any closer to that glass.
Oh, there you go.
That cooler could not be any closer to that glass. Dude, it looks nice. I like it.
No, I think it's pretty baller. As much as I rag you on it, I'm not saying it isn't a sweet PC setup.
It's
so can I mine Bitcoin on it in my spare time?
I don't know.
Probably could.
I don't know if you can with that graphics card. It's kind of a low-powered one. Never understood why all these people build these computers on YouTube. And then they never put the panel on the side of it to actually do their testing. They always have the panel off. You ever notice that?
Yeah.
It's like, come on, if you're going to show us tips, go ahead and put the stupid case together.
Whatever.
Okay, we're getting close.
Where are we?
96%.
Whoa. Finally.
Sad part is, we already did this. We did this last night. It was perfect. And then guess what? Dude, this looks all weird. It's a reflection on it. You know what? We're going to have to take that glass back off. That's why they do it.
No, I think it's funny to keep it on there, actually. I'm not going to lie.
We're going to see what happens when we fire the computer up, Steven.
Oh, we're just going to really just troll everybody with this point.
Oh, my God.
This is our take on trolling The Verge, everyone.
Okay, it's ready.
Okay.
So, let me turn this computer off. Let's switch over the
power cable.
Yep. Let's see. Power. Shut down. Okay, I'll move over the HDMI.
I gotta put those outside to dry. Alright. Take 20. I'm only half joking there. There, okay.
Okay. Okay, for the moment of truth, let's see if it works now. So I'm leaving the data cable disconnected for now until we get this loaded up, and then we will plug it in and deal with everything afterward as far as updates.
Yeah.
How bad does the screen look on there? Yeah, that's not horrible.
It doesn't really matter.
Okay, so next. Install now. Go ahead, tell us that we can't install Windows on this. Don't have a key. We're going to go Windows 10 Pro. That looks like it's going to allow me to go ahead and do it on this. Custom. We're going to put it on that one because that's going to be our NVMe because it's a 1 gigabyte compared to the 4 gigabyte. And then new. Okay. With it being a brand new computer, if I don't like the way it installed on there, I can always take and format everything and start all over, and I'm not losing anything.
Mm-hmm. Buys you some safety margin.
Yeah. I do like the way that case looks, though. So, was there anything on the motherboard as far as the LED?
I couldn't really tell, but I also wouldn't really know where to look.
It'd be down the bottom right corner. There should be a possible, because I saw there was a switch on there for turning the LEDs on and off on the motherboard.
Oh, okay.
So I may have to flip the switch. Ooh, powered off. It powered on. Yeah, I do feel the gloss coming out the top. That's good. It's a weird logo. It's getting ready, Calvin. It's Getting ready.
I hold my breath until it's done.
That's a sexy case. It's actually not bad at all. Yeah, it had plenty of room in the back for the cable management. It looks decent. It doesn't have grommets or anything in it, which would have kept you from seeing any cables in behind it, but for what it is, it's fine. Uh-oh. Guess that's normal. Actually, it is. It's just I'm not used to happening that off that fast.
Yeah.
This thing. I don't know why it came back over here. Shouldn't have clicked on any of that stuff at the very beginning. Maybe now it'll do what it needs to do. There we go. Let's see here. Where are we at? We're in the United States. US, yeah, probably. No. I don't have internet. Connect to unlimited setup. It's gonna be me. Keyboard not work here. There we go. Yeah, my password is going to be nothing. No, I don't want you to know any of my stuff. No.
Not that it matters.
I know, they'll turn it back on anyway.
Yeah. Surprised that hasn't turned into
Tina, or whatever her name is.
Surprised that hasn't turned into a court case yet.
Hi. We're getting everything ready for you. This might take several minutes. Don't turn off your PC. Your computer is being assimilated. Your computer is being assimilated into the continuum.
Oh my word!
Think of it. If Microsoft ever decided they want to take and just turn completely trolling everybody. Just think of all the computers they have control of at any given moment.
Why do you think
that is the fastest installation I have ever seen? Wow. Okay. I guess now's the moment, Calvin.
What?
Gotta plug the internet into it.
Oh, dear.
You want to do it or you want me to do it?
I'll do it. So if anything goes wrong, you can't say it was your fault.
Well, it's my fault anyway.
Is it the blue Ethernet cable?
The one that's plugged into the back of the computer down there.
Oh, right.
Probably is blue.
No, it's the one that comes in from outside. We're going to have to move the computer so we can plug this in.
Oh, really?
Yes. No, stop whining. It's not my problem your Ethernet cable's too short.
Is there another Ethernet cable there?
No. It's the old one that ran to outside.
Oh. Okay, well... Out there.
Yeah.
Let's see how fast this all happens now. Actually, there is one thing I want to do first.
What?
I want to go to Microsoft Edge. I want to open this.
And download Chrome?
Yeah!
Oh, gosh.
Well, anyway, there it is. It's running like a champ. We got the updates going right now. Hopefully by the time it gets finished up doing all the updates, I'll be able to maybe go to Windows 11 before this all said and done. I think it will. Turned out that in order to get on the internet, we had to pull off a driver for the network off of this little thumb drive that MSI sent with the motherboard. So we were able to get that up and running, and get on the internet, and download Chrome, and get rid of whatever that other one was. So guys, thank you very much for watching. Take care, and I will catch you in the next one. I'll play video games.